we are beginning a fresh topic, that is antiretroviral drugs. So, from the name itself, it's understood that they are used for the treatment of infection of HIV virus. So, we have to begin with the classification of the drugs. But before going into the classification, we have to know the steps in the life cycle of HIV, and thus we can come into the sites of action of the coming drugs. First of all, first step in the life cycle of HIV is its entry to the human cell membrane. HIV, where this protein coat and RNA gain entry to the cell membrane. After entry, it undergoes uncoating to give away its viral RNA. Now, viral RNA will get converted to viral DNA with the help of reverse transcriptase enzyme. Then viral DNA has to integrate with human DNA using integrase enzyme. After integration, the viral DNA along with human DNA give away viral mRNA by transcription, which undergo translation to give away viral protein particles, which on action by HIV protease give mature virus. So, this is the brief description of life cycle of HIV virus in human. Now, we have to consider the site of action of our antiretroviral drugs. First of all, the first point of inhibition begins with the entry of the virus itself. That is, first drug inhibit the entry of the virus to the cell membrane. Cell, that is, the drugs are entry or fusion inhibitors. Next group of drugs prevents the conversion of viral RNA to viral DNA. That is, they inhibit reverse transcriptase enzyme. And we have two classes of drugs that are nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitors and non-nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Next group of drugs prevent the integration of viral DNA to human DNA, that is, they inhibit viral integrase enzyme, and the group of drugs are integrase inhibitors. Then the last class of drugs, which prevents formation of mature viral particles, that is, virus protease inhibitors. So, briefly, we are familiar with the classification, that is, entry of fusion inhibitors, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, non-nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitors, integrase inhibitors, and protease inhibitors. So, according to the importance, we are coming into the classification proper, that is, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. And among these drugs, pseudomonin stands first. So before describing a drug, we have to know what we have to describe about a drug. That is, firstly, we have to write about the class of drug. Its spectrum is specified. Mechanism of action. Pharmacokinetics. Uses. Adverse effects. And drug interactions, if any. So, for pseudomonin, it's a nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, and from the name, it is analogous to one of the nucleoside. That is, it is a thymidine analog. So the class of drug is a thymidine analog nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Spectrum, it is active against both HIV-1 and HIV-2 infections. Mode of action, we know they prevent the conversion of viral RNA to viral DNA by inhibiting viral reverse transcriptase enzyme. Then pharmacokinetics, they are orally active, metabolized in liver by glucuronide conjugation. And excreted through urine. Now we know the use of the drug is they are used for the treatment of HIV infections. Now adverse effects and drug interaction. Adverse effects of pseudobulin are they cause bone marrow suppression, neutropenia, etc. And the common adverse effect that we encounter that is nausea, vomiting, abdominal discomfort. Comfort, then insomnia, headache, so and so. And an important set of drug interactions are there for pseudobulin, which come away along with its metabolism, that is drug interaction. First, it has drug interaction with paracetamol, and the pathway is that paracetamol also undergo metabolism by glucuronide conjugation in liver. So, it can compete with pseudobulin for metabolism, leading to a higher concentration, that is higher plasma concentration of pseudobulin. Next, azoles that are antifungal drugs that are actually microsomal enzyme inhibitors, which can also inhibit the metabolism of pseudobulin, giving rise to a higher plasma concentration of these drugs. Now, stavulin, which is another nucleoside reverse transcriptase, they can compete with pseudobulin for intracellular phosphorylation. Actually, the drug has to undergo two sets of phosphorylation, that is, they are converted to triphosphate group so that they become active in the human cell. So, these are the drug interactions. Now, we have a bunch of examples for nucleoside reverse transcriptase other than pseudobulin, that is, diadenosin, stavulin, lamivudin, abacavir, etc. For diadenosine and stavulin, they cannot be combined because they cause increased risk for pancreatitis, peripheral neuritis, and lactic acidosis. And another feature, that is more for mechanism of action, adverse effects, uses go along with that of pseudobulin. Now we are introducing another drug, that is a nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor, that is tenofovir. It is a nucleotide analog, that is analog to adenosine. It also has similar mechanism of action, uses adverse effects that of other nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Now we are going to the next class of drug, that is non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. They are active against only HIV-1 infections, not with HIV-2, and their mechanism of action is like they directly and non-competitively inhibit nucleoside, that is reverse transcriptase enzyme. But nucleoside reverse transcriptase can directly and commutatively inhibit the enzyme. Now, examples are efavirenz, nevirapine, etc. Their major adverse effects are skin rashes, vomiting, abdominal discomfort, etc. So these are the important points for non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Now we can consider protease inhibitors. They competitively inhibit HIV protease enzyme, which is essential for converting the immature viral proteins to functional, structural, and enzymatically important viral proteins, that is for the they are essential for the maturation of viral proteins. So by inhibiting these enzymes, the drug can actually inhibit the formation of virus which is capable of causing an infection. So among these drugs, the important ones are Entinavir, Nelfinavir, and Ritonavir. Nephrolithiasis is the main adverse effect of Entinavir. For Nelfinavir, diarrhea, and Ritonavir has another important action, that is it inhibits cytochrome P450 and has many drug interactions. Also, for Ritonavir we have to know another factor, that is boosted PI regimen. That is, when co-administered with another protease inhibitors, it can actually decrease the metabolism of other PIs, so that the amount, that is the dosage and the frequency of other PIs, can be reduced, so that there occurs a boosted action of the drug. That is the important point we have to know about protease inhibitors and especially Ritonavir. So we are going to the next class, that is fusion inhibitors. We have to know two main drugs, that is enfuvirtide and maraviroc. Enfuvirtide actually prevents the fusion of HIV-1 virus cell membrane to human cell membrane, thereby preventing the infection. And one thing we have to know is that enfuvirtide is given subcutaneously, so that the adverse effects are pain and erythema on the site of injection. For maraviroc, it is a CCR5 chemokine receptor antagonist. That is, they can prevent the fusion of CCR5 chemokine receptor, that is the viruses which are tropic to CCR5 receptors can be prevented from fusing with the cells. That is, it is a CCR5 chemokine receptor antagonist, and the adverse effects and other metabolic pharmacokinetics are same as that of other drugs we have already studied. Then final group of drugs, that is integrase inhibitors. Only one drug we have to know, that is raltegravir. Mechanism of action is understood, that is they prevent the action of integrase enzyme, which is essential for the integration of viral DNA to host DNA for its replication and further infection. And another important thing is that it is active against both HIV-1 and HIV-2 infection. Pharmacokinetics adverse effect goes along with the previous drugs that we have discussed. That's all for today. Thank you.